Good Wednesday morning, July 4th. This is the Great Basin Fire Potential Briefing for the next 7 to 14 days. Looking at the short term for today, Thursday and Friday, we do have wind concerns, mainly across western areas, especially across parts of Nevada. Winds could be gusting over 30 miles per hour, humidity again in the single digits, and just the isolated threat of some lightning across far southern or southeastern Utah. Not very widespread either today or tomorrow, but as the wind concerns diminish, by Friday we should start seeing the first edges of what will eventually, later this month, become the monsoon. First lightning in a long time in some very dry areas in our south. So we're highlighting those areas down in southern Nevada and parts of southern, central, and eastern Utah as we go into Friday and especially this weekend. In addition, for existing fires, high Haynes indices of 5 to 6 will exist along with critically dry fuels, which could lead to explosive fire growth. In the past 24 hours, we've had a little bit of light precipitation. A lot of this didn't really reach the ground, just a few hundredths of an inch to a trace. We did have some lightning on the drier side. Not a lot of it, but across northern Utah, parts of central Nevada. And current and existing fires had some new fires in that band of lightning that popped up through here. New fires in the red, existing fires either in the yellow circles or the purple circles, which indicate not just large fires, but team fires as well. Observed precipitation bone dry the past 7 days for just about all areas, and percent of normal, of course, that's closer to 0% in what is typically a very dry period. So here are our fuels, and these purple circles you see here across much of Utah are 97th percentile to record levels. We have not seen in many years this much dryness, or this much in the way of purple circles across this large of an area of Utah, and now getting into southern central Nevada, also getting into the 80th to 90th percentile. A lot of the 50th to 70th percentile is now pushing not just into northern Nevada, but into southern Idaho as well. And it's not just the dead fuels, it's the live fuels as well. Out in the Carson District, live fuels taken a little while ago have dropped down to below normal early July levels. Down in Pine Valley in the Oak, they are below normal and between normal and record dry levels. And in southeast Utah, sagebrush down at record dry levels. Satellite imagery shows another low pressure trough. It's been the pattern across the Pacific Northwest, and this will provide a little bit of breezy conditions across our western areas. There is some pseudo monsoonal moisture developing here with these clouds across New Mexico and Texas and down into Mexico itself. As high pressure gets organized and pushes from the Texas area into the Four Corners, some of this moisture will approach as well. So for today, there's the low out here. Some of these tighter packing of these yellow height lines indicate there'll be some better winds through here from the south and southwest. And this is where we have our high risk for wind across parts of the central Sierra front and stretching across a good portion of Nevada into parts of western Utah. And where the winds kind of diminish and aren't as critical in Utah, we do have high Haynes indices. So for current and existing fires, more growth is expected. Here's our wind concern, most of it again across Nevada. You can see here these orange are gusts in the 20s to near 30. A little bit in Utah, not as much. No significant precipitation here except just a little bit south of the border, but we could see a little bit sneaking in into our far southeastern areas. Now on Thursday, you see this big, broad, high pressure starting to take shape and build northward, and there are some blobs of moisture starting to develop, not much into our area yet. We could see some isolated lightning in some of our driest areas here in southeast Utah. This is where we have high risk. Notice how many of our PSAs have gone into the brown. And some blips of precipitation in this model. This model tends to sometimes overdo it. I'm not sure if I buy this stuff further north into the Uintas, but some of the stuff in the towards the Moab area and the Manti-LaSalle Mountains is quite possible tomorrow. Winds not that bad tomorrow, but worst in western Utah and a good portion of Nevada, but staying below the 30 mile an hour critical stage, maybe 20 to 25 gusts. On Friday, there's the high building in. We are going to heat up. Look at that brown already pushing into southern Idaho. We have a little bit better chance of lightning as some moisture starts skirting the Arizona Strip into far southern Utah, maybe into some higher terrain in far southern Nevada towards Mount Charleston. This is our precipitation map. Again, the northern edge is probably overdone, but the southern area south of I-70 is quite likely, so we could see some lightning there. Winds there fairly light. 3 day precipitation totals, not much at all, even though there'll be some moisture above. Low levels are very dry. further down the road Saturday. Notice more moisture now pushing up into southern central Utah, into a good portion of Nevada. We have high risk now expanding, becoming a bit more widespread across our southern areas. Further north, fuels continue to dry. Sunday could be a pretty big day lightning-wise. We're not in a deep blob of moisture, so the rainfall at the surface, not very heavy. Fuels are near record critically dry levels. And afterwards, with more moisture Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, we probably will see a bit of moistening going on in the southern area, so we have not issued high risk. You see here in Utah quite a bit of this dark green. We could finally start seeing some more widespread wetting rains reaching the ground, but some models differ at this point. For the next 7 days, precipitation amounts should be fairly light. 8 to 14, the outlook. The long-range models have now hit on the monsoon to come in a little quicker. They were slower with it before, but it looks like by July 11th onwards, we should be into the brunt of it across Arizona, southern Utah, and especially pushing up into Nevada, the way the upper-level winds are tracking. This concludes our briefing. Have a great day.